Alrighty guys, how's it going? I'm back with some more Sly 2 Band of Thieves, and when we left off last time in the last recording session, we had just finished, I think it was a Sly mission, and we had to pickpocket a ton of keys, so that was kind of annoying, but now there are two more missions before the heist, and that is Crip Hacked and Tank Showdown. So we're going to do Murray's first, head over there, and I don't know if you guys can tell, but I'm not sick, but my throat is kind of sore, so I don't know if it's going to mess up me talking or anything, but if you hear me, you know, make any mistakes or my voice crack or something like that, that's why.
Murray, use both analog sticks to drive the tank. Press both up to move forward, both down to go in reverse, and in opposite directions to rotate. To fire your turret, tap the R1 button. You'll need to take out six tanks to get the job done.
Alright, awesome time. We get to use a tank now.
You know, the seat's gotta go back farther than this.
And I was kind of wondering what this door is right here. And I guess it's the enemy, the Contessa's tank storage or something. But the tank controls are kind of weird. You have to... Yeah, Bentley, we heard you the first time. Alright, I guess I can just run over these guards, because they're dumb like that. But these other tanks... The hard part about this is the other tanks will shoot at you too. And so, yeah, that's what makes it hard. It takes three to kill each tank. And we've already got one, so five more, because I'm good at math like that. I wish I could be better at these controls. Oh. Oh. Aw, come on. Get that guy. Come on. What? That was three times. I shot that guy three times. That's some BS right there. Definitely shot him. Alright, is this him? I think this is the same thing. Okay, I guess it varies on how many times you have to shoot him. Oh. Shooting at me? Okay, this is going to be a standstill right here. I'm just going to take you out. There we go. I guess we can get health from enemies and stuff that we run over to. And, alright. So this isn't too bad. Need some more health, though. That would be helpful. Oh, yeah, I'm dead. That was... And, wow, okay. He shot the cannon. And then I shot mine, but I killed him first, and I still blew up, because that makes sense. Okay, let's try to do it better this time. Maybe, like, reserve these guys and take their health only when needed. I couldn't find any more guards over there where the other tanks were. Man, we were halfway done. I was doing good that time, but let's try to get this guy from far away. I guess the key is to move around so you don't get hit. Maybe, I don't know. For some reason, the last time I played this, I thought I did pretty good at this, but... Alright, let's chase this guy down right here by our safe house. Man, why can't I control this thing? I'm horrible at this. Okay. Let's try to get this guy. Okay. Why am I so bad at these controls? Man, this is annoying. I guess he's too far out of range. My guy can't aim at him from there. There's a lot of guys in this courtyard area. Let's try to get this one. Is there a guy behind me? Yeah, there is. Sneaking up behind me. I don't think so. Biatch. Alright, so we're halfway done again. I wonder if I could shoot those airplanes. That would be pretty cool. Alright, let's try to take this guy out. There we go. I guess it is three hits, but that one guy was taking like five or six. I gotta run away. I don't want to die here. If I could control this easier, I could run away better, but I can't. Where's that last tank at? There he is. I see his light way over there. I see you. That first bullet just went right through him. There we go, I got him. I can't find any health. I guess you just have to be really good at this and do it all without getting any health. Except for right there at the beginning. I guess if I had let those guards stay alive. Actually, you can get health out of stuff like this. Yeah, there we go. I got some health out of the chair. I guess that makes sense. I mean, it doesn't really make any sense, but how you can get health and coins out of tables and chairs, but it works for me. I mean, it's better than nothing. I'll take it, is what I'm trying to say. I sneak it behind this guy. There we go. Alright, so that was it for that mission. You can actually do it really quickly. I did it in like 6 minutes, but I bet if you were better at controlling the tank, you could do it a lot faster than that. But yeah, now all we have to do is head back and turn into Bentley, do his mission, and then we can do the heist, and we'll be done with episode 5. Or, yeah, this is episode 5, right? For a second I was thinking 6, but that is incorrect. Mundo. I always get that word wrong, even though it's not a word, it's made up. Correctamundo. Sometimes I say correctamungo. I don't know. I have no idea what I'm talking about right now. I have zero idea. Alright, let's go do cryptac, because we're not... Haven't we already done enough crypt stuff here? We got the bad mojo. We got through a bunch of them with Sly to get the voice modulator. And now we have to go back in with Bentley again. Instead of getting mojo this time, we have to do some hacking. Which is just as fun, if not more fun. I'm gonna put you guys to sleep. Unless that stupid-ass bat calls more friends. I was shooting you! You know what? In times like these, we must... Yeah, jump to our death. How about that? Yeah, no. In times like these... Don't jump to your death. That'd be a better idea. I was trying to run away with my adrenaline rush, but I guess that didn't work out. Should have used this in the first place. That always happens when I come back. Like, I'll get done with a recording session, and if I haven't recorded in like a day or two, then I like forget everything on how to play really well, if you know what I mean. Like, forget all the shortcuts and stuff, and all the power-ups that I could be using. Alright, yeah, so we get to go back into some more crypts. I don't know if this is the same one or a different one, but now we've got to hack stuff. So this should be fun.
How are you going to hack the computers down there when they've got no power?
According to General Clawfoot, mobile energy source is stored at the end of this hallway.
Hallway is a pretty kind term for what looks to me like a complex medieval gauntlet of death.
Yes.
That pretty much sums it up.
With whirling, razor-sharp spikes might scare me. In fact, terrorize my every fiber. It's the only way to power up that old computer at the re-education tower. Without that thing online, we'll never get at the clockwork eyes or free Carmelita.
You're a good man, Bentley. Just make sure those traps don't rip you into 100 little turtle pieces.
Why'd you have to say that?
Yeah, so earlier, like when we fought, what the hell am I talking about? When we first got here to episode 5, I was thinking about this one mission where you have to get through a bunch of traps, and I thought it was a Sly mission, but it is indeed a Bentley mission, and this is it. There's like a ton of traps, and they get progressively harder as you go along. So yeah, this first room is a piece of cake. So, like he said, we have to get all the way to the end of this entire, like, underground crypt area to find like a battery type thing to power the computers, and then we hack those computers, and every time we hack one, it powers up a part of the computer in the tower, the re-education tower or whatever, and once we get all the computers down here powered up, it will completely power up the re-education tower computer, and that'll be it. So I'm just jumping through here doing some parkour stuff. Oh, I got by those spikes. I don't know how I got by them. By those, I guess, would be the more correct term. I don't see how that room's that hard. I never found that last room right there to be that hard, but a lot of people think it... Okay, yeah. All right, jump right in the water. We got another room like this with octopi. Octopuses. And here's the battery right here, and the first terminal that we have to hack.
Acid battery should do the trick. Just walk close to the electrode and voila! Prepare to be hacked, you knave!
Alright, so we've actually got some hacking stuff here. And I guess these guys are like really slow, but there's going to be like a ton of them at once. So I don't really find it that hard, actually. I actually like these enemies because of how slow they are, but I think there might be like a mini boss in this hacking terminal. Like, I think in this mission, sometimes you see him a lot in Sly 3, but there will be, every time you do a hacking thing, there will be like a boss at the end that's like, you actually have to do a bunch of stuff to defeat. Okay, no, there's not. There's just a guy with a gun. He's definitely not the boss. Or a gun. A cannon.
I'll get you, Contessa.
Oh, how many times must you say that? It's not going to happen.
I'm dead serious. I'll get you.
I'll get you. I'll get you.
I mean it. I'll get you.
Yes, yes, so I've heard.
And since we've got that computer, one little piece of the three turns on in the tower.
I'd better not take any damage while carrying this battery to the other terminals. It is, after all, filled with acid.
Alright, so that's the great part about this mission. Okay, Bentley, shut your mouth. Okay, like, that is the fun part about this mission, is you cannot get hit or get hurt or you'll blow up, so you do get a checkpoint at every like computer that you hack, though, so it's not that bad. But you just gotta be extra careful. And that room is not really that hard. I think probably the one with like the swinging axes is probably the most annoying one. Okay. Oh! Oh! Oh my goodness. Alright, here's the next computer. Barely made it by those spinning, smashing things. Oh great, now they've added in some of these fast guys, are you kidding me? Oh! Doing 360s, getting rid of these hacking firewall things. I don't know what to call them. Little red dudes. Little red bots. Bots is a good word. I think I might use that word. Probably forget it and just keep calling them dudes, but you know. Let's finish up with this room, and I wonder what's going to be like before the little thing that we, I don't really know what to call the thing that you go into, like the green thing at the end of each course that you go into, like that thing. I guess call it the hole, the green zone. All I've got down here is just another guy with a cannon, so it's not that bad.
Should approach this through your id instead of your conscious mind. It might help to get around your super ego.
Yeah, throughout this this recording session, I'm going to be trying to like drink a bunch of water so my voice, my throat, you know, doesn't mess up. Doesn't mess up as much because I've already had a few. Oh, I've already had a few. Not voice cracks, but you know, my throat messing up and stuff. Alright, I'm gonna wait for these axes to kind of even out like that. There we go. And oh no! Are you kidding me? I was right there at the end. You've gotta be kidding me. Alright. Alright, Bentley, shut your mouth. Oh, I don't know how I made it by that, but alright. Whoa. Alright, this is the... I'm kind of an impatient person sometimes, especially when it comes to puzzles like this, so... Sometimes, most of the time, I'll jump the gun and mess everything up, but I finally made it past that part, and looks like we've got one more room, and I think the last terminal's on the other side, so. And there we go. Oh, here's the it's right there behind the wall. Alright, so after we do this one, we'll be done with the mission, so. Not that bad. Oh, damn! What the hell? We've got, like, extremely fast guys now. They're not messing around. Whoa! Calm down. Get away from me. Get away. And these slow guys just keep spawning and getting in the way, so that doesn't help. Alright, I'm trying to break out of here as fast as I can. Get away from these freaks. These little red bots. You're not catching me. Woohoo! Okay, yeah, here's the boss I was talking about. Most of the time I just go around in circles. It's pretty easy, you know? It's not hard at all. That's pretty much it right there. If you just go around a circle, like circle him and keep shooting, yeah. It's pretty easy.
Inspector Fox, why fight it? Don't you want to be my friend?
No, you horrible eight-legged cow. No.
That old computer powered up. My work here is done.
I guess Carmelita thinks she's a cow, apparently. Doesn't really look like one. I think that's called the spider Carmelita, but oh well. We're done with Bentley's mission. And I think we're going to have, yep, one last PowerPoint before the heist.
It's time to wage war on the castle, and in the confusion, pull off a heist I've named Operation High Road.
High Road it is.
Murray will take down the spotlights on the main gate with the codes provided by General Clawfoot. Then, with the help of the voice modulator, I'll order Neela's forces to attack. Sly will then paraglide the two of us over to the Contessa's getaway blimp, and we'll use it to get inside her re-education tower. The assault on the castle will undoubtedly draw the Shadow Guards off their post, and if we free Inspector Fox, she's sure to clear out the Contessa. With the Mind Shuffler exposed, I'll plant the bad mojo bomb, and presto! The Clockwork Eyes are ours! So if the two of you are ready, let's take our positions and get this thing started!